Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, let us start with let us now start with construction of context-free grammar for the for loop. First, let us try to discuss an example on for loop and how for loop executes. Over here, we have taken a small example, a for loop, which is initializing using I is equal to 0. If I is less than 5, it will go for the execution of the statement x is equal to x plus I. After that, it will go for increment of I is equal to I plus 1. Now, for this particular program, we are supposed to construct a grammar. Let us discuss the grammar. The statement could be a for statement or some other statement. A for statement start with a for. Within bracket, there might be initialization statement, a condition check, and an updation statement. At the end, there is other statement which has to be executed on following the for loop. The condition could be either an arithmetic condition which evaluates to 0 or 1, or it may be a Boolean expression depending upon the condition. An initialization statement could be a variable equal to some value. An updation statement could be a variable equal to some expression. Now we have to parse the program that we wrote using this particular grammar. I have constructed parse tree for the program. A statement over here is a for statement. It contains a for followed by bracket in which there is initialization part followed by a termination semicolon. Within the initialization, we have a variable I initialized to 0 using the equal operator. Finishing the initialization with semicolon, we enter to condition. The condition is a Boolean expression. Over here it is I less than 5. Going back, we terminate condition with a semicolon. We go to the updation of the statement. The updation is of the form variable I equal to I plus 1 over here. Completing the updation, we close the bracket and then we come to the execution of the statement. The statement to be executed over here is x is equal to x plus I, which is parsed followed by a semicolon. Hence, the parsing yield of this particular parse tree is the program which was expected. Over here, we have constructed grammar for various constructs such as arithmetic operators, if statement, if with else statement, and various operators such as loops having do while loop, while loop, for loop, etc. Using these kind of constructs, actual programming languages are constructed, but they involve a lot of complex grammars such as using such small constructs. Even real world programming languages are constructed such as C, Java or C++, etc. But they will have much more as compared to simple grammar that we wrote here. I hope that these videos help us in viewing various programming constructs. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda and do subscribe.